Good morning, everyone. The last day going home. So we're going out Pabeni Road today, or Pabeni Gate, and then on towards Graskop, and then we're going to do the Panorama Route, just to capture those last images that everybody would need to come to look at and see, like God's Window, Three Rondavels, all the different waterfalls. So this is all for malasafaris.com. Let's capture those images for him and see what we can get. Leaving Pabeni Gate on the way now to Graskop. It is a public holiday, and this is how the cars are lining up to come into the park for a one-day safari. More than enough reason to come to the park. It is popular.
Turn left on R535. Continue straight for 20 minutes to R533.
So I get these WhatsApp messages from a site which is the latest sightings at the Kruger National Park. And as we've just left here at Pabeni Gate, the sightings WhatsApps are starting to come through, claiming that there are lions at the Shatlavi Dam, right at the entrance to the dam by the H11. I drove that road 5 days long, twice a day almost. Never saw a lion. There was nothing happening at Shatlavi Dam either, so just our luck that we didn't get any lions, more than what we got on day one and day two, but that's the luck of the draw. We are on our way to Graskop. Let's see what's happening there.
Turn left on R533. In 9.2 kilometers, you'll arrive at Graskop Gorge Lift Company. Your destination will be on your right.
We got here to the Graskop Gorge Lift Company. Unfortunately, we're still too early for them. They are not opening for another hour. And we have another few places to stop and see. So unfortunately, we can't stay for the hour to open up and see what's going on. So let's get to the next place and see what is available and open.
right on Lisbon Falls Road. In 2.1 kilometers, you'll arrive at Lisbon Falls. Your destination will be on your right.
Past nine, we're now here at Lisbon Falls. It is beautiful, a lot of water coming down, and as I said, it's time for coffee and biscuit, or coffee and rusk as the English would say.
Road.
We're here by Berg's Luck, and it's a stunning day outside. I haven't been here for a while, and it amazes me every time that I'm here that, you know, the water is rough. You know, it's making and breaking rocks like wear and tear, erosion. It's unbelievable. So do yourself a favor, come check this. This is something unique.
Thank you.
we're here at Three Rondavels. This is the last part of our trip. One useless piece of information is the fact that I've never been here before. I've been all around South Africa to most places that I can think of, but this is one that for one some funny reason I've just never been here before. So I might take slightly longer than usual, as this is fairly new to me, and see what I can capture for you guys. So this is the wrap, 6 days away, stunning photos at the game park, now more stunning views of the panorama. It's time to go home. 400 k's, here we go. One thing that I've realized being here by the Three Rondavels is that the time of day definitely makes a big difference. So for any visitor coming with a camera, video camera, whatever you want to do to capture these images, make sure you do it in the later afternoon when the sun is setting to the west and it then really shines beautifully on top of the Three Rondavels and the dam specifically. So small tip for any photographer, do this in the afternoon. Just entering Dalstroom, which is obviously a very popular place when it's long weekends, bikers coming down, a lot of curio shops, sightseeing. But because it's a public holiday, everybody now needs to get home, and so the traffic is quite hectic. It's going to take some while to get home, but there's no rush.